Welcome to the first of the Component Modeler tutorials. In this tutorial, we will show you how to set up a new area and get you started. This is the first of a series of tutorials. First, open the CADMATIC desktop. A new Component Manager area has to be created within a workspace. Navigate to the correct project. If no workspace has been created yet, create one for yourself as a user. Enter the workspace. Go to Object, Create Area 4, and select Component Manager. Only one Component Manager area can exist in a workspace. Double-click on the Component Manager to start it for the first time. When starting for the first time, it is required to create default views. We recommend creating the following views: Top, Front, Left Side, and XO1. In this case, we create the front view in wireframe and create the other views shaded. Make sure all views are set to shaded by pressing All Shaded and only change the front view to wireframe. Press OK to confirm the creation of default views. A new window appears called Manage Component Model Objects. In this panel, you can see two databases: the library name, followed by the .lib extension, and the project name, followed by the .pms extension. Inside each database, you can browse equipment models, parametric models, and structural components. In this example, we will create an equipment model inside the library database. When a component is created in a library database, it can be used in all projects connected to this library. Select Equipment inside the .lib browser. A New button has appeared in the upper left corner, which can be used to create a new GDL for equipment. These actions are the same for the creation of structural components. After the creation of a new model, attributes can be set. To change these, press Select Attributes. These attributes are user-specific, but we recommend to at least use Description, Author, and Date attributes. Select None to deselect the current selection. And select Description, Author, and Date. Press OK to accept the attributes. You can now fill in the values. Press OK to accept. Now we can optimize our screen layout. Make sure the Component Manager window is maximized. Press the Arrange button located in the lower right corner. From here, we can arrange the default views we created earlier. The views can be stacked horizontally or vertically over multiple screens. You can slide the divide bar to change the size of the views. We recommend to use vertical stacking for these four views. Press OK to confirm the arrangement. You are now ready to start building the component. You cannot save until you have placed at least one node and one primitive. To find out how to do this, please continue to the next video.